Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss a prose from First Flight named Two Stories About Flying. Now this story has two parts, so today I will discuss the first part, and that also not at a time. Okay, I will divide it and discuss part wise, maybe in three parts. So the story, the two stories about flying, his first flight. Now this is about a young bird, a young seagull, and who is afraid to fly, means taking his first flight. Okay, now when the human being, a baby, okay, when he starts walking, he takes his first step, so that time there is a sense of fright inside the baby's heart. Okay, the same thing was happening to the bird Sigul. Okay, now he was also very very scared, afraid to take his first flight. Now but something happened, okay, and after that he tried and tried hard, and at last he succeeded to take his first flight. Now let's discuss how he got the success. Now the young seagull was alone on his ledge. Now ledge is a narrow horizontal shelf projecting from a wall or a cliff. Now cliff means a vertical rock. Now here a ledge is a horizontal platform on a rock. Okay, there is a mountain and in between there is a ledge. Okay, so the young seagull was alone on his ledge. His two brothers and his sister had already flown away the day before. Now the young seagull had two brothers and one sister. So both his brothers and his sisters, they had already flown away the previous day, means one day ago. He had been afraid to fly with them, but he could not fly with them. Okay, and that's why he was left alone on that ledge. Somehow when he had taken a little run forward to the brink of the edge and attempted to flap his wings, he became afraid. Now what happened? He ran, okay, from one end of the ledge to the brink. Okay, but after running, okay, coming to the brink, he attempted to flap his wing, you know, flapping, okay. So moving wing up and down, he attempted to flap his wing in order to fly, but he became afraid. Now what happened? Why he was afraid actually to fly? The great expanse of sea stretched down beneath. Now underneath, okay, means from where the ledge was sitting, okay, trying to fly. Beneath, okay, down there was a sea, okay, and looking at the great expanse, the great stretch of the sea, okay, he became afraid. And it was such a long way down, and also the depth, the height, okay, from the ledge down to the sea was a great height. Okay, it's long way down, miles down. He felt certain that his wings would never support him. So he bent his head and ran away back to the little hole under the ledge where he slept at night. So what he did? Okay, he felt certain, he was sure that his wings would never support him. So if he tried to fly, he was sure that his wing would never support him. So he bent his head and ran away back to the little hole under the ledge where he slept at night. So once again, okay, he went back to the same position where he slept at night. So where did he sleep at night? There was a hole inside the ledge, okay, under the ledge. So he went to the same hole, okay, and stayed there, left, okay, flying. So even when each of his brothers and his little sister, whose wings were far shorter than his own, ran to the brink, flapped their wings and flew away, he failed to muster up courage to take that plunge. Plunge here means that jump, okay, or to throw away your body, which appeared to him so desperate. Desperate means in dire need, okay, of something. Means he was trying hard. He was in dire need of flying. Okay, so this is the desperate situation. His father and mother had come around, calling him shrilly, upbraiding him, threatening to let him stab on his leg unless he flew away. But for the life of him, he could not move. Now, what happened the day before? The day before, his two brothers and a little sister, okay, and their wings were far shorter than his own wing. Now, they mastered up courage and they took their flight, okay. They were able to fly. But the young Segul, he was not able to take that plunge. Plunge means to throw his body, okay. And that plunge appeared to him so desperate. He was so needy, okay. He was in dire need to take that plunge, but he was unable. So his father and mother had come around calling to him shrilly. Now, shrilly means in high-pitched and piercing sound, okay. Upbraiding is scolding him, threatening to let him stop on his ledge unless he flew away. So his parents, mother and father, they were calling him shrilly, they were scolding him, they were threatening him that they would let him stop. Stop means to die without food, okay. So they would let him stop on his ledge unless he flew away. So when they were threatening him that if you don't fly away, okay, then we will not give you food. You will remain starving on this ledge, okay. But for the life of him, he could not move. But he was very afraid, okay. He loved his life very much, the young Segul, and that's why he could not move, he could not fly. That was 24 hours ago. So this incident was 24 hours ago. Since then, nobody had come near him. So since then, nobody had come near. Nobody here refers to his parents, his brothers and sisters. The day before, all day long, he had watched his parents flying about with him, with his brothers and sisters, perfecting them in the art of flight, teaching them how to skim the waves and how to drive for fish. So the day before, means when they flew away, his brothers and sisters, he had watched his parents flying about with his brothers and sisters, okay, and his parents were teaching his brothers and sister, sister, okay, how to perfect themselves in the art of flying, in the art of flight. Now, teaching them how to skim the waves. Skim means to move lightly just above the surface of water, okay. So how to skim the waves, how to dive for fish, you know, dive to take plunge inside the water. So how to dive for fish. Now, Segul. The Segul's main food is fish, okay, and their prey is fish. So they catch fish by diving into the water, okay. So he had in fact seen his older brother catch his first herring. Herring here refers to a soft, fine sea fish, okay. So he had in fact seen his older brother catching his first herring, devour it means to eat quickly, okay, hungrily, standing on a rock. So how did he was devouring his food? Standing on a rock while his parents circled around, rising a proud cackle. Now cackle is the cry of bird. So his parents were circling around his big brother, older brother, okay, and they were rising a proud cackle, rising a proud voice, okay. So why proud? They were feeling proud that their son, okay, was able to catch his first prey. And all the morning, the whole family had walked about on the big clay to meet way down the opposite cliff, taunting him with his cowardice. And all the morning, his whole family, they were also standing just on a big plateau. Now, plateau means a table land, okay, a plain land on high elevation, on height, okay, on high height. So their family was also standing, okay, they on the opposite plateau, okay, and the opposite plateau was midway down the opposite cliff. So just opposite to that mountain, okay, and they were taunting him, okay, taunting him in means they were making mockery, okay, of that young Segul that he was not able to fly. Okay, so means what you can mocking him. Okay, so mocking him, taunting him. Okay, because of his cowardice. Okay, so up to here in this part.